looking for customers for the unused buildings and launch pads on the Space Coast. WESH 2's Dan Billa reports members of Congress think the U.S. has been too slow to turn over launch facilities to job-creating private businesses.
Not too long ago, 18,000 people worked at the Kennedy Space Center. Now it's 8,000.
I think that we missed the boat in not commercializing or privatizing earlier.
Congressman John Mica brought an entire congressional investigative panel to the Kennedy Space Center for a hearing on how to more quickly turn over old launch facilities to job-creating companies. For some of NASA's old equipment, there may not be much commercial use. For example, does anyone need a pair of old trailers built to carry a huge space shuttle fuel tank? But when it comes to buildings, facilities, and hangars, there is commercial demand. There are some success stories. All three of the old space shuttle hangars are becoming home to new spaceships. A mini shuttle is expected to use another building, the operations and checkout building. But Air Force General Nina Armagno says the government can't just open the door to anyone.
Well, I also have to balance the fact that I can't decrease the value of the military value of Patrick or Cape Canaveral Air Force Station.
That's why some businesses are looking for non-government facilities in other states for their space businesses.
We basically choked the golden goose to death with red tape and overregulation.
Only three of the 47 launch pads at the Cape and Kennedy Space Center are in use. Witnesses told Mica's panel more business will go overseas or to other states unless conversion from government to business comes faster. At the Kennedy Space Center, Dan Billow, WESH 2 News.